Your Berks Craftsman on BCTV is supported by the Kutztown Folk Festival and by the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen. BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.
I'm Carol Haile. This is Your Berks Craftsman. I'm the education chair for the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen. And this is probably the most fun event that I do the entire year, second, of course, only to my doing our shows, that is. Because one of the missions of the Guild is to inspire and reward upcoming artisans and craftspeople, because that is the future of our Guild. Now, so that we can get on with looking at all these stuff, all these wonderful things, and talking to the teachers and some of the students. The Stanley Gissell Student Awards is something we take very, very seriously as a guild. We give very sizable cash awards to winners, and we will have a group of four judges who will come in a few days, and they will take their job as judges very, very seriously. We give two prizes in fine art, a first prize of $100, a second prize of $75, and we give, of course, because we're the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen, we pay particular attention to crafts. And so we will give first, second, third, fourth, and even awards of merit. And there's cash with these prizes as well. In addition to these awards, we have special awards that were created in honor of some of our most beloved craftspeople in the Guild. And the first one I will mention is the Burkhart Gerhardt Family Award. Jean Burkhart, who was an internationally revered pressed flower artist, well known at the Philadelphia Flower Show. He would win all sorts of silver plate cups and such. He created an award in honor of his family. And so he would come and he would choose. So what we do, now that we give the award for the Burkhart Gerhardt Family Award, is we try to channel Gene. What would he look for? Because a lot of the work he did was collage. And I did a little run through earlier, and there's a lot of collage here. So we have judges, we have a lot to consider here. We also give the Hetty Miller Fiber Award, and that is always a triumph for us because it encompasses weaving, batik. Hetty Miller died at the age of 101, and she always wanted to do things that were new. So every time she did a show, she would have new items, and so we look for fabric items that have Hetty's flair and her sense of adventure. Then we have the Ruth Ann Hartung Two-Dimensional Award. We lost Ruth Ann. She was our calligrapher. And her work was exquisite. And so what we try to do is match the student's work with her precision and calligraphy items, fractur, and it's specifically for outstanding examples of fractur and calligraphy, but it has quickly become an open category because we don't generally find too many items of that description. And most of our awards are reserved for seniors, and so sometimes we have to use a little bit of flexibility in seeing a very splendid calligraphy piece, perhaps done by a freshman or a sophomore. We use our judgment. The Wiblouter Award for Best Traditional Work. There's a lot of pottery here. Usually the pottery takes that award year after year, so we're going to be keeping our eye out for items. I saw a very unusual quilling project. You don't see much quilling, and students that are into that are very detail-oriented, and so we like to award our money to students we see has an affinity for those sorts of arts that over the years have been lost for the most part. So, and then we have the Richard M. Loper Memorial Award. Richard was a master craftsman in woodworking and carving. Last year, for the first time in many years, we found work worthy of the Richard Loper Award. It is for a senior, it is $100, and we look for that special woodworking project that is worthy of Richard Loper, something that he would award if he were here to choose the item. And then our last award is our most prestigious, and it's not awarded every year. It's for the best of the best. It's the Stanley G. Seltz Award for Outstanding Achievement in Design and Craftsmanship. What we look for is a really splendid piece of work, but then we look at the other items in that school's display and see if there are other differing items that that same student has done. And so last year, the awards recipient entered three fine artworks, one in pencil, one in acrylic, another in watercolor, also a small sculpture, a weaving, and several other pieces which illustrated the breadth of her ability. And so we judges have a very difficult job sometimes, but from what I'm seeing here, this year is not going to be any different. It's going to be difficult. And so I'm going to interview some of the people that are still here. Some schools are already set up. This is very exciting. Lots of noise, but the gallery is coming together. Okay, let's move on. Teacher from Reading High School. I've seen you before. Tell us what you have brought.
We have artwork ranging from 9th through 12th grade with multiple art classes being represented and a lot of different mediums.
How do you choose the items that you bring?
Basically, for myself, I can't speak for all the other art teachers at Reading High, but for myself, anything that I find worthy of the art show would be some of my top work. Somebody who's really strong compositionally, but also in their skills.
Since we are the Reading Berks School of Craftsmen, have you brought pottery, jewelry, any items that might get one of our top awards?
We do have some ceramics projects this year, and I'm trying to think. We have a couple of things that we've categorized as textile, but it's kind of printing on muslin, and also painting on fabric as well, some fabric painting.
Wow. Weaving?
I don't have any weaving this year. We started school a little bit later this year, and so we're pushed back about 2 to 3 weeks. So some of the pieces we typically have aren't quite ready yet.
That is usually an issue with having this particular exhibit in February and early March. Yes.
Yes.
Well, I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Get back to work.
Thank you.
What school do you represent, and what is your name?
My name is Rhonda Tommel. I represent Olie Valley High School.
Tell us what you have brought.
Well, we've brought a good amount of two-dimensional work. We're just getting ready to put out our three-dimensional work. And just things from a range of media, so.
Olie Valley always does a very splendid job with pottery.
Right.
Have you brought a lot of pottery this year as well?
Yes, we have a lot for you to look at.
Excellent. Well, we'll be judging on Friday, and we'll pay particular attention. We have, of course, our craft awards, first, second, third, fourth, all with cash. And we have our Wib Louder Traditional Work Award, which has frequently gone to an Olie Valley student in the past. So we're very anxious to see what you've done. Now, what have you brought in the fine art?
Fine art, well, Actually, what you see on the wall is most of what we have in fine art. We do have a couple of sculptural pieces as well. We have a new faculty member this year who comes from a sculptural background, so we're seeing a lot of that.
Do you have any wood items? Last year, we had some wood items. A gentleman from I don't know what school, not yours, he built a guitar.
All right.
And we got very excited about some of the wood projects because it was the first year that we could award our Richard M. Loper Memorial Award. He was a woodcrafter, and so the award is in his honor, and so we try to reserve it for those types of projects.
Of course. No, we don't have any wood items this year, but it's definitely something that we're going to keep in mind for the future.
Well, I hope so. Well, much good luck and success.
All right, thank you so much.
What we failed to get on film, this board was in motion. This gal dropped a hammer, I think. Things are falling off the wall. It's such chaos. I mean, this is the way it goes when you hang a gallery show. People do not understand, for the most part, the work that goes into setting up a display, certainly of this magnitude. Tell us your name, dear, and what school you represent.
I'm Jessica Alexander. I teach art at Conrad Weiser High School.
So what did you bring?
We brought a variety of artwork from foundations of art, 2D design, photography. Yeah.
Since we're with the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen, have you brought any objects that would be of particular interest to us? Pottery, jewelry, weaving?
No.
No?
No. Well, we brought two sculptures with us that a student made out of recycled plastic.
We give awards, two awards in fine art, several awards in crafts, but, you know, the sky's the limit. Your work is wonderful.
Thank you.
We'll let you get back to putting this all together, and I won't bother you anymore.
Thank you.
Thank you. We're finally ready to talk about this wonderful artwork behind. And what is your name and what school do you represent?
So my name is Zach Ruger and I'm a student of Daniel Boone High School. I'm a senior and I'm in AP Art.
And this is all Daniel Boone's work?
Right, this is a collection of our drawing and painting program as well as photography and graphics. And we have pottery and 3D design over there.
Wow. Okay, would you like to give the mic to this young lady and she can tell us her name and what have you brought to this?
Hi, I'm Alexis Stein, and I am an AP 3D student, so I brought a couple of the 3D pieces.
Good luck.
My name is Noah Humphreys. I brought a large amount of food-based jewelry, and I'm a senior in 3D.
Wonderful.
My name is Quentin Reyes. I'm in AP Studio Art. I just actually have a couple of my photography pieces, black and white and color.
Excellent.
My name is Kobe Conway, and I'm an AP Art. I brought some of the drawing and beach-based projects.
And this?
My name is Maddie Rotter, and I am in AP Photography, and I brought photos and a mixture of 3D work.
I'm with the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen, and this segment will not end up on the cutting room floor, I'm sure, to talk about what we do here with our Stanley G. Selt Student Awards project. And we seek to reward students. We have sizable checks, $100 for certain awards and so forth. We have several awards in fine arts. But we focus on crafts. So the judges will be all over your crafts. We encourage pottery, we encourage jewelry, we encourage 3D, and we'll be very interested to see. I saw an agate jewelry.
I don't think that was mine.
Oh, was it yours?
No, that was Steph's, I think.
Well, anyway, it was beautiful. It was beautiful. So I wish all of you the best of luck, and thank you for taking time to talk with us.
Thank you so much.
Uh-huh, good luck. What is your name and what school do you represent?
My name is Kaya Bauer, and I'm from Reading Muhlenberg Career and Technology Center.
And you were saying how much fun it is to come here and set all this up.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, not only is it a little bit of a day out of class, but it's also, you know, I know everyone who made every single piece up here. So it's awesome to actually put up their work and to be able to display it for everyone to see.
Well, I'm with the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen, and this segment will probably be on our Your Berks Craftsmen show in March. And the Reading Muhlenberg Career and Technology Center is a consistent winner over the past few years,
yes,
especially photography, and you've been branching out into some interesting and exciting new areas. Mm-hmm. Tell us what you brought.
What pieces I specifically brought? Well, let's see. This is one of my pieces. This is one of my pieces, and this actually had already won an award.
Oh my.
We put this one in the middle because it's, you know, it's all around you, just kind of a theme going along there. And
wonderful.
Sorry, excuse me.
Yes.
This piece up here is mine. This piece here is mine. And this card right over here is also mine. Just a holiday card. We do that project every year, but they always end up really nice, and we get those printed out. And there is one other thing. This is a design piece that I made. It is a card game based off of the school. I was the summer intern at RMCTC, so made a game.
Wow, your students are quite creative.
Yeah, you know, we have a really wide variety of just different art styles and what people like, so, you know, everything that everyone is doing is usually unique and amazing, and a lot of people grow a lot with each piece they make.
Yes, the judges for the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen have quite a challenge always to keep
absolutely
up with the energy of the emerging artisans that we encounter here.
Yes.
Because frequently we're just old-timers and we have difficulty keeping up with the digital world and all that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. So this is wonderful to know, and I wish your students the best of luck, and thank you for speaking with us.
Yes, thank you.
I'm here at Antietam High School's wonderful pottery and artwork. What is your name, and what did you bring?
Tara Halverson, and we brought a big mixture of drawing, painting, ceramics, design, computer graphics, photography, textiles, watercolor. Yes, a little bit of everything.
I have a question, because we are the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen and we give substantial awards. Do you try to gear your students in those directions, specifically to bring items early in the year to this rather than saving them for the end of the year?
We have some two ceramics classes that run in the fall as opposed to the spring. So we have a lot of those classes, and I currently have a fibers class, which is a spring class that replaces one of
those. We have our Hedy Miller Fiber Arts Award, and yes, you have quite a collection here. I did a run through earlier, and the judges are just going to have a terrible time. Terrible time.
It's a good problem to have.
Very good. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Well, you're a familiar face.
Tell us
who you are and what school you represent.
Chris Allen, Governor Mifflin High School.
And tell us, what have you brought?
Well, we brought a whole variety of work again this year, from our visual arts students, our AP art students, multicultural students, digital art students, so it's a whole variety of work.
Have you brought any wood projects?
This year, we do not have any wood projects because, I don't want to say.
Okay, well, that's the way it goes. Last year, we were overwhelmed. Of course,
right,
we're the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen,
right,
and we have a specific award for wood projects.
Yes.
And we love to give that award.
I know.
And last year we were able to do it, not just once, but maybe two or three times. And it was so satisfying. So I'm on the particular lookout, so will the other judges,
right,
for wood objects. But at the same time, did you bring other pottery,
yes,
jewelry?
We have pottery and we have basket weavings and all our 3D work. We have something different this year. We did handmade paper and made paper lanterns out of them. So we have those this year, which we're really excited about. But none of that's up yet. Our 3D work, we're still getting ready to put up.
Well, we're early, and we'll let you get back to your work. And
we'll see you
soon.
I love their jackets.
Thank you. This is a familiar face. This is a familiar school. Tell us your name and what school you represent.
I'm Biba McKamey, and I teach at Wilson High School.
So you were setting these pieces up.
Right.
Tell us more about them.
Well, we have a traditional crafts class and we have a paper crafts class. So the recycled newspaper bowls are from the paper crafts, as are the quilling. And we have a handmade book. We did that this year, and is now we're doing the traditional crafts, so we're doing the basket quilling.
Quilling is something that is, it's a very old art. A very old art form, and I'm seeing several pieces of quilling around here. Yours is extremely unique.
They were supposed to make some kind of a radial design, so I left it at that. It was kind of before Christmas, so they kind of got a snowflake idea, but we had some limited colors. We didn't have very much white, so they made them very colorful, and I'm real pleased with the way they turned out. Well, it's fun.
I know the judges, we're going to have a hard time
every
sorting
year.
All of this out. So what other items have you brought?
Well, we have quite a talented group this year of painters and drawers in the 10th, 11th, and 12th grades. So we've got a variety of acrylic, oil, printmaking, drawing, color pencil, oil pastel, all of everything.
How do you choose what you bring here?
I'm sure it's very difficult. So hard. Especially as they age, they get stronger with not only their skills, but what they want to say with their work. And their expression comes out more. And so we like to choose those versus just an assignment. You know. So.
Well, thank you very much, and I'll let you get back to your work. Thank you. You are so hard at work here and so reluctant to talk with us because you're so busy. Tell us what you have brought and what school you represent.
I'm here representing Wyomissing Area School District.
You gotta practice.
We have a variety of work. Do you want me to talk about the 3D stuff in particular?
Well, whatever you feel is most eclectic, perhaps.
Okay, well, I know you're here representing the Guild, and
yes.
We had some classes this year that are new to our curriculum. So we were doing some pieces in functional wear with fibers. So we've introduced felting and fibers into our one of the classes, so we had some examples of that.
Yes,
that were
we have
really
the
nicely
Hedy,
done.
The Hedy Miller Fiber Award. I see mosaic.
Yep, mosaic. We
batik,
did some jewelry
that's
making.
Batik
with fabric and dyeing.
I see some weaving over
yep,
here.
Some
oh
crochet,
gosh,
work.
Crochet work.
Yes. And
look
the three-dimensional
that.
Crochet as well. So this is Harold, our little alpaca.
Harold,
yep.
How sweet.
So it is student. And just a variety of
this
different.
This is like a granny afghan.
It
this
is,
goes
yes.
Way,
the,
way
the
back.
The classic
in Berks,
granny square,
in Berks
yes.
County culture.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
but
it's quite an achievement.
Time-honored craft,
yes.
and the students really enjoyed learning the traditional process.
Wonderful.
And then taking what they learn with the traditions and adding their own.
So you're their teacher?
Yes.
And what is your name? I failed to get that.
That's okay. Laura Zamperini.
Thank you, Laura, for telling us, and get back to work. This school is hard at work doing some paperwork on the floor. What is your name and what school do you represent?
My name is Isabella Hotzel and I am from Schuylkill Valley.
And are you a student or a teacher?
I'm a student.
Okay, and what work is yours? What have you brought?
Currently, as we can see, I brought this one and I have one over here.
Oh, so you have some fine art as well as some craft.
No, I did more of a canvas piece.
Oh, a canvas piece. Well, what other items have you brought for your competition?
We have many masks that we started working on this year, as well as we have a lot of paintings and photography as well.
So what is your what is the favorite thing that you have done and brought?
That's a really good question. I'd say painting.
The painting?
Mm-hmm. The paintings. We have a lot of really good ones.
The Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen gives 2 awards in fine arts and a lot of awards in craft. So we encourage people to do crafts. Look at this quilling project. That's very unique. Some years we see no quilling, and now this year we're seeing a lot of quilling throughout this exhibition. That's how it goes. Thank you for talking with us.
No problem.
Let's give a hand to our young children, our kids here, our brilliant artists. My God. This week actually marks 4 years since I've been the executive director here at GoggleWorks. My name is Levi Landis. I came from the museum world in Philadelphia. And when I first heard about this show that we've been doing here annually, I said, what are we doing with that show in our premier gallery? Does that make sense? You know, it's from the museum world, you can get a little snooty, right? So, and then I see this work from all of your young people here, and it got me. It blew me away. Most of the work in this show becomes my favorite work that I see in our galleries throughout the year. So you ought to be proud of your young people. You ought to be proud of yourselves if you have work in this show. It is quite exceptional. And I've come to meet some of you and get familiar with your work as I walk past it every day. So thank you so much for that. On the line of thanks, I do want to thank some others. Most specifically, I want to thank Stacy Kilgore and Brenda Robertson from the Berks County Intermediate Unit. Please give them a hand. Without their work, this show wouldn't happen, and they do an incredible job of herding the cats, quite literally. Stacy told me there's over 1,100 objects in this show, so we really pack it in. And again, you guys do an incredible job of your teachers making it look great, especially you young artists that have made incredible work. Thank you so much. I also want to thank Megan Kerber over at the Berks Art Alliance. The Berks Arts Council. Give her a hand. And Constance Folk. They're a small staff, but they do mighty work, so they're doing a great job. I also want to thank our friends at the PA Guild. I know Barry's right here. They give scholarships for young artists that are working in wood and craft. So thanks to everybody that's supporting these artists in different capacities.
Now, without further ado, I'm going to introduce our first awards. They will be presented by the Berks Guild of Craftsmen, and Barry Benikoff will do the presentations.
Thank you and welcome this afternoon. This is always a great honor for me to come up here and present these awards. These students are so talented. We were in here Wednesday night and looked over the display, and it's just unbelievable. I mean, you got to be very proud of these kids. Now, I know we're going to repeat this too many times, but let's give these kids another round of applause. Award winners, if you do want to see yourself on TV, be sure you stay by your artwork down there, and BCTV will film you and we will interview you if you're interested. We're going to be taking some photos, and we're hoping that's not a problem because we will put these things on our website. Award winners, check out our website, rbcrafts.org. There'll be applications up for a student show at Kutztown University in fall. So without further ado, we're going to get on with our awards. First one is for Karen Mendoza of Wilson, the Burkhart-Gerhardt Family Award, $100. You want to come up and receive your award if you're here. Normally, on previous events, we had the award winners come up that side and exit that direction. Just come on. Makes it much easier, keeps the traffic flowing. Next one, Diana Arena, Schuylkill Valley, the Hedwig Miller Fiber Arts Award, $100. Alyssa and News. Suski, I'm going to mess some of these names up. Governor Mifflin, the Ruth Ann Hartung Two-Dimensional Award, $100. Sasha Joseph Fleetwood for the Richard Loper Memorial Award, $100. If the student's not here, if there's an art instructor here, please pick up these awards. Devin Stark of Ole, the Stanley Stelz Award for Outstanding Achievement in Design and Craftsmanship, $100. In the years we've been doing this, these awards, the Stanley Stelz Award has only been given out twice. So this is quite an honor. This takes some superior work. Yeah. Morgan Leese, Governor Mifflin, first prize, fine arts, $100. Kimberly Santos, Muhlenberg, second prize for fine arts, $75. Lily Dang, Schuylkill Valley, third prize for fine arts, $50. Elizabeth Deal, Kutztown area, first prize for crafts, $100. Medina Mavlanova, Boyertown area, second prize for crafts, $75. Quinn Nepper, Connor Weiser, third prize for crafts, $50. Kevin Bartosh, Fleetwood area, fourth prize for crafts, $25. Micah Rogers, Fleetwood, Award of Merit. Caitlin Creswell, Daniel Boone, Award of Merit. Thank you, and I think you're going to see quite a few of those names come up again.
If you are here and there are awards that you, students did not pick up today, if you could come and pick them up and take them back to the school with you, that helps us in getting them to the students. Remember, award winners, to go check out your display and participate in the photos and the interviews. And everyone, enjoy the afternoon. Thank you so much for coming.
I'm speaking with Brenda Robertson, the head honcho here, who pulls this all together, and it has been fabulous. Tell us about how this all transpired.
Well, it's definitely a team effort. It's not me alone. We have a few really active people on our committee that help pull this together. Mrs. Stacy Kilgore from the BCIU is the key person who keeps us all in line and moving along. Chris Allen and Mike Miller assist, and Kristen Egan here at the GoggleWorks really help with the whole committee. And there's a few other people as well.
My guess is you're already working on next year.
Always. Every year we think about what went well and what could we improve and take steps to make things better.
Well, my guess is, from what we have seen here, is that arts and crafts in Berks County are in very good hands. and our teachers are to be complimented, certainly, for the wonderful work they have brought to this exhibit.
There were over 1,700 pieces in the exhibit this year, and there were over 1,100 students.
And us judges went home with massive migraines.
I can imagine. I don't know how you make a choice. There's so much wonderful work.
Well, that's why we bring three or four, because the more eyes, the better. And thank you so much, Brenda, and keep up the good work.
You're welcome, Carol.
I'm here with Diana. How is it pronounced?
Diana.
Arana. And your school is?
Schuylkill Valley.
You have won our coveted Hetty Miller Fiber Arts Award for your beautiful batik pillow. Tell us about the pillow.
It was kind of actually just for fun. I wasn't really thinking about making it because I made a first one and then that one just came out because I really like sunflowers, so it just happened.
Well, your joy in making it, having fun with it, that is what we interpreted from this, and that's probably why it caught the judges' attention. What does that tell you about your artwork, maybe?
I guess that I'm good at it. I don't know.
Not only are you good at it, but when you're joyful and when you bring that emotion into your work, it shows. So what are your plans in the future?
I'm not planning on doing more artwork because I'm not really good at it that much. But I'm just gonna do like some social work, maybe. Not really sure yet.
Well, congratulations on your award, and you made us judges very, very happy.
Thank you.
I'm speaking with Kevin Bartosz. You took our fourth prize in crafts with this incredible cabinet. Tell us about the cabinet.
Well, it's just an idea I made with my one woodshop teacher, Mr. Heck. Got to shout him out. And all my classmates, including Sasha Joseph, we all worked hard in the woodshop, and we enjoyed what we were making. And it turned out pretty well. I'm very happy with the turnout.
Where did you get this wonderful piece of walnut?
I got to thank my woodshop teacher there. He found that, and it turned out perfect because it made the project really stand out.
About how long did you spend on this project?
It took a couple months. We had to go through the plans, make the plans before we made it, and it turned out very well in the end.
Well, we certainly appreciated it. And are you planning to do more woodworking in the future?
For sure, definitely. It's definitely something I'll be doing when I get older, and it's a hobby of mine. I really enjoy it.
Wonderful. Do you have plans in your future beyond doing woodwork?
Yes, I do. I'm going to go to college and hopefully get a degree of my choice, and I'm very excited for the future.
Well, hopefully we've contributed a little bit to making that happen.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
And thank you. I'm here with Sasha Joseph. That's your name?
Yes.
Tell us about this amazing table.
Basically, it's just a coffee table for my mom. We're putting an addition on our house, and she wanted a new coffee table for our...
It won a prestigious award, the Richard M. Loper Memorial Award. We have only dusted it off in the past year because there were very few wood projects here, but we had our choice. Tell us about why did you keep the rough edge? It is so delightful.
That was actually probably the hardest part of the project, was keeping the rough edge, because the wood we had to work with was actually like all different heights and lengths, so it was hard to get it to the same thickness. And so we kept it basically just because I liked the look of it, but that was probably the hardest part to work with.
What are your plans in the future, Sasha?
I just want to go to college and be happy, I guess. I'm not sure if I'm going to go into woodworking, but it's definitely something
I
like to do.
Of course, very few people do go into woodwork,
right?
But it is something they do to decompress at the end of a very
stressful
day.
Definitely,
yeah,
and I'd say that's exactly what it's like for me, too. Like, it's a way to relax. You can just, like, work on your project and get everything out doing that.
Well, congratulations on your splendid achievement, and congratulations on your wonderful award.
Thank you so much.
Richard M. Loper, were he alive, would be very, very pleased.
Thank you.
Caitlin Cresswell, how delighted we are to finally speak with you. Tell us about this wonderful violin.
Well, it took me a very long time to decide on what I would paint for an acrylic project at school. And then I realized that the colors of a violin that I have that's antique would look really beautiful. And then I selected sheet music, which is larger than life, because I like the meaning of it. And yeah, I would title it larger than life also.
Because
You won quite a few awards. I saw you going up frequently.
Yes.
So what grade level are you?
I'm in 11th grade.
So are you planning to do more artwork?
Yes.
So next year you'll be a senior and you'll be eligible for many more of our awards. We only gave you the award of merit based on your beautiful watercolors down there.
Thank you.
We didn't even see this, but it is exceptional work.
Thank you.
We wish you much good luck and success in the future.
Thank you so much. It's much appreciated.
I'm here with a big winner at the BCIU competition today. Tell us about this work.
So I guess this is a painting I did. And it, I guess it classifies as surrealism. I spent like 2 months on this. It constantly changed as I was painting it, and this is kind of my final outcome.
And this is a fast lane art selection. How does that work? Now, this will be entered in a larger competition. How does that work?
From what I know, yes, it will be entered in a larger competition where I could be selected to be put on a billboard and have my art around Reading.
Well, now tell me, what are your plans after you graduate from high school?
So far, I'm looking into colleges. I do not know yet what I want to do. So,
what is your age?
I'm 18.
18. So you're graduating soon.
Yes, I'm graduating this year.
All those decisions are big ones to make.
Mm-hmm.
We wish you every success.
Thank you.
What is your name and what did you win?
I'm Kylie Loeb, and I won second place in printmaking.
Oh, that's not all you won, dear.
I also won the Fast Lane Award and an honorable mention in the sculpture.
So tell us about this particular piece for which you did win a second place.
We were actually just working on that in class. We did a project entitled Nightmares, so we got to choose whatever we wanted as the subject matter for the prints.
What year are you in school?
I'm a senior.
You're a senior. What are your plans once you graduate?
I'm going to Kutztown to study art education.
How wonderful. Well, now, you must apply to do, because you will be a student at Kutztown University, you must apply. It's free of charge to be in our student gallery. Our show will be at Kutztown either the last weekend in October or the first weekend in November. Make an application and we hope to see you there.
Yep.
I'm here with Devin Stark, who has won the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen's highest award, the Stanley G. Seltz Award for Outstanding Design and Accomplishment. Tell us, Devin, how is it possible that you get so good in year after year?
It's a lot of hard work. I keep myself passionate and dedicated, and I love the whole process. It's just everything for me. It's my entire life, and I love it.
The joy in your work speaks so loudly to us.
Thank you.
And you won this award last year, and it is one that we rarely give,
yeah. But
only to those who do the most deserving work. Do you think you will be able to join us perhaps in the fall in our student gallery?
Yeah. Yeah, I would be honored.
Well, all of that information is in your packet. What are your plans after you graduate?
My plans? I want to look around in colleges, just kind of take a break from school for right now, just like center myself and experience some more ceramics.
Well, there you go. Well, wonderful, wonderful, wonderful work. Congratulations on your award and much success in the future.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm speaking with Emerson
Pacini.
Pacini, and tell us about this lovely batik.
Yes.
Batik pillow.
So we did these last year, and I did it in the spring. So we didn't get to put them in the shows, so I decided to put it in here. But our whole class, we were making pillows, and we used wax to do the design and then some watercolor ink to put it in. And it was really fun to do. I've never made a pillow before, so it was very interesting. But I think it turned out pretty good.
It's lovely. Yeah, good enough to win you a nice award. So you're in 11th grade.
Yes.
What are your plans for the future?
I hope to follow art as a hobby, but I actually want to go into pre-vet sciences. So, along with the side, just a nice side hobby, but yeah, it's really fun.
A lot of the smartest people in the world are really good at crafts, really. And so we wish you the best of luck, and we look forward to seeing something wonderful again next year.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm here with Ryan Murphy. Ryan, tell us about your award-winning robot.
Well, in my graphic design class, everyone had to make a robot with a certain function, and since I think airplanes are really cool and they just look really cool when they're flying in the sky, I said, you know, I'm going to make my robot flying and base it off of an airplane. So there it is.
And what won a first place award in design. It has such energy. I mean, you can see it flying just off the page. Was that your intention all along?
Well, when I was originally making this, my teacher, Mr. White, these were like a solid color. It took a while for it to really take effect. Like, this was a solid color. Mr. White was the one who chose me to add a gradient. And like also these two over here. And yeah.
Okay, you're in 11th grade. Do you plan on doing more of this work and entering it next year?
I'm not sure what the future holds for me. I am planning to go on to college to look for stuff like this. I'm very into it. I enjoy doing it. And yeah.
Well, we wish you the best of luck, and thank you for coming on Your Berks Craftsman to talk to us about your amazing work. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Micah, if my records are correct, you're in ninth grade.
Yeah, I'm in ninth grade.
And you won an award of merit that did not bring any money with it.
Yeah.
But your table, we had to award it because your future is so bright. Tell us about your table.
So it's made out of three different woods. The ends are live edge walnut. They still have some bark on the ends there. And this is cherry. And this is maple, but it has ambrosia in it, which is from a moth going into the tree and leaving those marks. You can see like the holes where
yes,
it exited.
Yes.
And I used steel for the legs, and I bent it with an acetylene torch, and there's lag screws underneath that.
Did you enjoy making this
definitely,
table?
Definitely, yeah.
Are you planning to make more in wood?
Yeah, definitely. I make cutting boards outside of school and sell
you
them.
You do?
Yeah, and chess boards and all that stuff.
Well, you will notice in our packet is an invitation to join us at our student gallery, where we give you free of charge a table, and if you need electric, we provide it, and you may sell your things or just show them off. So that show will be in the fall, either the last weekend of October or the first weekend of November. And some of our students in our student gallery do very, very well. So maybe you can bring some of your woodwork and you can sell it at our shop.
Okay, I'll look into that. Yeah.
Well, you...
Yeah.
I'm here talking to Morgan Lease, our first prize winner in fine arts. Tell us about this wonderful, wonderful piece of art.
Thank you. This is like a recent picture for my AP Studio Art project. It was part of a series, and I always work with dots, and for this one I wanted to go big. And I ended up just doing a self-portrait of myself in this like wedding dress that I thrifted that I took a picture of. So yeah, I just kind of went with it, and I was just kind of...
It has an ethereal quality to it because of the pointillism, which is very unique and very difficult to do.
Yeah.
And the title of it, Wedding Day, is... Us judges we went... It was like... This is it. This is very. What are your plans for your future?
Well, I don't have exact plans for after school, but I do want to, like, whatever I do, incorporate artistic talents and just creativity day to day. You know that.
So you got another award also? Tell us about that.
Actually, this was a forum that someone had said about the art of jazz, and I'm really involved in my music program at Governor Mifflin, a few different things. So I want to look into it just because art and music, it's not an award, but I am interested in entering and
well, you go for it. You go for it. And congratulations again. You won $100, which should help you towards your plans for the future, and much good luck to you.
Thank you.
I'm here with the winner of our Ruth Ann Hartung Two-Dimensional Award. Ruth Ann Hartung was a very dear friend of mine, died quite suddenly. She was the calligrapher of our guild, and her award she would have chosen this. Tell us about it.
So this is a fish piece that I did. It was inspired by one of my friends who went on a trip to Jamaica, and he was sending me all these really cool pictures and stuff, and it really just inspired this piece to have a whole bunch of color and a whole bunch of fish.
It's very much an illustrative, it's got an illuminated manuscript feel to it. It's got this wonderful and vibrant border, and the colors are so well balanced. Do you do other work of that nature?
I do. I really enjoy like the intricate work with different colors, and I like to plan out my color schemes a lot.
Okay, are you a senior?
I am a senior.
And what are your plans once you graduate?
Hopefully to travel and see a little bit of the world, see a little bit of the culture and the art.
Yes. Well, we gave you $100, and hopefully that will go toward making all of that possible.
Thank you.
And congratulations again. Ruth Ann would be so pleased.
Thank you.
What is your name and what school do you represent?
My name is Lauren Urey, and I'm from Twin Valley High School.
And what is the award-winning work that you did?
I did this yarn coiling piece on a piece of wood, obviously. And, I mean, yeah.
So what went into it? Did you have to think a lot about it? Did you do a lot of planning? Did it take a long time?
Well, usually for like yarn clothing pieces, it's like baskets and things that are more conventional. I wanted to do the opposite. So I wanted to do something that you could hang on the wall, and it wasn't as uniform. It was more like free-flowing.
Well, and you won the first place. What did you win?
It was first place in mixed, wait, I can't remember what category it was.
Well, it's certainly deserving of that. And you're in 11th grade. What are your plans in the future?
I'm not sure. I think I might want to go to art school, or at least minor in art of some sort. Other than that.
Well, we in the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen will be looking forward to seeing your work next year, I'm sure.
Thank you.
And you'll be planning more of expressive work of this nature?
Yeah, I'll definitely do more of yarn coiling. I really like that media.
And it's relaxing, I'm sure. You find it relaxing.
Like, some people find it very repetitive, but I just like it. I find it fun.
Well, congratulations again, and much good luck in your future, and it was wonderful talking with you.
You too.
We're speaking with another Fast Lane winner. What is your name and what school are you attending?
My name is Clea Gregoris. I'm a senior at Connor Weiser High School.
And tell us about this wonderful piece.
So the prompt for this assignment was value. We were told specifically to look for black and white pictures in a magazine. We then created a collage out of that and adapted it to our own art style in forms of paintings. We had some people do ink, but I chose to go with acrylics because I thought I could get some really good blending. My main goal was to try to work with the idea of value and show sharp contrast with my black and white and then the nice blended area around where the woman's face is so that you could see some of the more graphic details and then some more nicely blended.
And what grade are you in?
I'm a senior, so 12th
grade.
You're
a senior, and what are your plans when you graduate?
I'm going to go to Chatham University to major in environmental science and hopefully continue on and take some art electives while I'm there. I've done some other work using plastic bags as a medium, so I'm hoping to kind of continue on that route and see where I can blend my passions, where it will take me.
We wish you the best of luck in the next competition.
Thank you.
And so maybe we'll see your work on some billboards.
Yep, thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you. As I said to Brenda earlier, the arts and crafts in Berks County are in very fine hands. The future of art in Berks County is secure. The students did phenomenal work, and I encourage anybody who has not seen this exhibit, if they have not seen it this year, certainly come next year because plans are already in the work for it. This is your Berks Craftsman, and I'm Carol Haile, Education Chair for the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen. Be sure to tune in next time for another interesting hour on BCTV.
BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.